Good morning students, I am Pavan, your science master. This class is going to be a very special class for you students, because I have invited Master Shashivardhan, who is studying 6th standard, but he is going to answer for 7th standard questions. And this class is going to be an interaction class. So I and Master Shashivardhan, both of us are going to interact to each other, and you are going to listen that, and you please try to understand what interaction is going on between both of us. Okay students, thank you, let us start. Let's welcome Master Shashivardhan. Come Shashivardhan. Hi Shashivardhan.
Hi sir.
Can you say hi to your friends?
Hi friends.
Okay. Shashi, which class are you studying?
Sixth.
Sixth. But I am going to teach you 7th standard science. Will you be able to answer to the questions?
I will try.
Good. I observe confidence in you. You are very confident. Nice. That's right.
Thank you.
Keep it up.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, Shashi. In the previous class, when I was teaching here, you are sitting before me, and you noticed that what were the points that we talked in the previous class, right?
Yes, sir.
Can you recollect the points, and can you say the points, at least few points from previous class?
Okay, sir.
Yes.
The chapter name is Heat and Temperature.
Okay.
And I learned from that. What I learned from that chapter is, in the previous class, I learned about what is temperature and conversion of heat.
Good.
And heat is a form of energy.
Good. Heat is a form of energy. Right. So, in this video, you are going to learn about how to measure the degree of hotness or coolness.
Okay.
And what device is used to measure the degree of hotness or coldness?
Thermometer.
Good. Thermometer is used to measure the degree of hotness or coldness. You know what is the degree of hotness or coldness?
I don't know.
The word, scientific term, is temperature. The degree of hotness or coldness is called
temperature.
Temperature. Okay. You just only remembered the word, the temperature, but what is temperature should also be remembered. Okay?
Okay.
Right. So here, to understand the degree of hotness or coldness or temperature of any object, any material or any living body, we have to use thermometer. Got it?
Okay.
We have to use what?
Thermometer.
Thermometer. See here, there are different types of thermometers present, and some thermometers are used to measure materials, right? That thermometers are called laboratory thermometer. And if the thermometers are used to measure the living body temperature, that thermometer is called clinical thermometer. And some, especially in living beings, in human beings, you see that infants there. Who are there?
Infants.
Who are infants? 0 year babies. Okay. Below 1 year of children there, no? So those children are called as infants. And infants' body temperature is measured using another thermometer called thermistor thermometer. Okay?
Okay.
And then if you want to measure the temperature of the atmosphere, there is another device, that's 6 maximum and minimum thermometer. You know, the temperature is a component of weather. Okay, not only temperature is the component of weather, there are different components present in the weather. Temperature, humidity, wind, okay, and light, sunrise and sunset, you know. So these are all the components of weather, components of weather on the earth. Got it? These are all the components of what?
Weather.
Weather on the earth. And especially, we are talking here only about particular component of the weather, that's heat and temperature. Okay?
Okay.
heat and temperature and heat and measurement. Got it?
Got it.
So here, to measure the heat and temperature in the atmosphere, the temperature is varied between maximum and minimum temperature. You know, to measure the maximum and minimum temperature of the atmosphere or the weather, there you need to use another type of thermometer that's called 6 maximum and minimum thermometer. Okay, got it? So you will learn all of these types of thermometers in this chapter. Got it? And then here especially I would like to explain about the construction of thermometer. Okay, did you ever observe any type of thermometer in your daily life?
I observed.
What type of thermometer you observed?
When I got fever, I went to hospital, a doctor kept thermometer in my armpit.
Good. So what do you think the thermometer is? What type of thermometer do you think that?
Clinical thermometer.
Good. Clinical thermometer. Right? Clinical, the term is relevant to the medical and medical sciences. Okay. Did you keenly observe what is the thermometer made up of?
I did not keenly observe.
Okay. I will show you the thermometer. Okay. I will show different images of thermometers you can see here. Students, I will show the images of the thermometers on the screen, you to observe, and you please try to understand what type of thermometers are those. Got it, students? Right. Shashi, here I would like to show the different parts of the thermometer. You know, this is a construction of glass. You know, it's looking like a glass body, right? What is the body made up of?
A glass body.
Glass body. See here, different parts present here, and at the base, you know, you can see here, at one end of the tube, you observe a bulb here. What is this?
A bulb.
Bulb. That's called glass bulb. And it is filled with what? Mercury. It is filled with what?
Mercury.
Mercury is a chemical substance. And why only mercury is used? Why not other materials used? And all you will learn in your coming classes. Okay?
Okay.
And here mercury has special properties with the component of the weather, that is temperature. Okay, that reacts. It's very sensitive chemical to the temperature. And you observe that one end of the tube is with a glass bulb, and what about other end of the glass? It is enclosed, right? You can see. And this is a glass stem. It's a long tube-like structure there, no? You already said that the body is constructed with glass body, right? So this is the stem that we call, this is the long part of the body, glass tube. Okay. That is called stem. And inside the thermometer you can see some mark. Inside the thermometer there is a structure like line. What is that line called?
Capillary tube.
Good, capillary tube. That's right. So you know, Shashi, the thermometer is sealed or enclosed by removing the air from inside the thermometer, you know. And do you find any markings on the tube? Do you find any markings?
Yes.
Yes, you can find some markings marked on the glass surface, right?
Yes.
And what do you find there? You find scale, which is marked to express temperature in degree Celsius. You know, to measure the degree of hotness or coldness or temperature, there is another unit called Celsius. And we read the temperature with the help of these markings. We read the temperature with the help of these markings present on the glass tube here. Okay, we measure
markings on the glass tube.
We measure the temperature with these markings. Got it?
Got it.
See, Shashi, here this arrangement of the marks is called scale of temperature. What do we call that?
Scale of temperature.
Scale of temperature. Okay, next. Actually, the thermometers, all thermometers work based on the expansion property of a matter. Expansion property of matter. So here a matter is used to measure the temperature. A matter expands on heating. What is the matter used in the thermometer?
Mercury.
Mercury is a matter used to measure the temperature, and it's very sensitive to heat, and we can observe that it very easily expands with very small changes of the temperature. Okay, like that. So here there is a new word that you need to understand. What is that? Expansion. What is that?
Expansion.
Expansion of matter. You know, there are different materials and matters present in the nature, and they expand on heating. You know, with the changes of temperature, they expand. You know, basically liquids expand on heating, that we have to understand here in this chapter. Okay, of course, metals, solids also expand on heating. On heating, the materials change their shape, change their state as well. Here we are talking about expansion property with liquids. What?
Expansion properties with liquids.
Very good. Expansion property with liquids. So here, to understand liquids expand on heating, there you have to take water as a liquid. What? Water as a liquid, and we have to heat it, and we have to understand whether it expands on heating or not. Okay, students, I hope you all enjoyed this interaction based teaching, students, and I just want you to imagine that you are in the place of the boy, and you try to answer yourself. And if you want to communicate with me, and you please comment in the comment section. And I hope you all enjoyed this. Thank you for listening, and thank you for knowing.